School News is launching a new channel, and we started by visiting VERULAM High School in a small town called VERULAM in Durban, eThekwini. We went to VERULAM High School to see how they work, how they function by interviewing the staff members and principal.
Bullying. Just
no,
You impact society on so many levels. Of course, you impact the lives of your learners, and through them, you wish that they would communicate this information all, so you can also affect the societies, and thus, South Africa as a whole will benefit. Listen, it's been a challenge for the children. There's no doubt about that. This is a new normal that we're looking at, and as such, we had to adapt our teaching methods. And also, we needed to bring the parents on board, more so now than ever before. With regards to adapting our teaching methods, we had to now seek technology, the use of technology. And now I'm thinking, why didn't I ever use it to the extent that I used it last year? So although people may be looking at the pandemic as being a closure on the official school system, it has opened up so many avenues to the teachers, to the children, and to the parents. And of course, yes, via the challenges and not having a continuous line of teaching for the children, it's going to impact them negatively to an extent. However, with the greater lessons that they have absorbed through the pandemic, because education is not just...
Did they achieve very well last year?
Absolutely.
When it comes to physics?
Life sciences. Even in physics, we had, I think, over 90% pass. Life sciences was 100% pass. And these are the gateway subjects. And our children did excellently. We were commended for our
results. In a short time. How many years have you been here in VERULAM Secondary
School?
30 years.
Yeah.
Wow. How do you feel if you work with Mr. Kavanda?
Oh, like Mr. phenomenal. In fact, we've been through many principals, and each one of them has had their own flair to education.
This is our hospitality. This is basically what we use to complete our consumer practicals as well as our hospitality practicals. And we have quite a few learners that have shown an interest in the subject.
Yes.
Right across from grade 10 to grade 12.
Yes.
So with the whole COVID situation, this setting has helped us tremendously. Because previously we were just working with our 4 stoves, and now we actually have so many more stoves. We have 10 stoves to use. And Mrs. S. Chetty actually found that this has also
The first thing that attracts your eyes or attracts you, if you can, the first thing?
The cleanliness.
Yes.
Cleanliness.
Wow.
The school is very clean.
Yes.
It means it's been taken care of. So you know when the school is clean, your investment is safe.
Oh, all right. So, yes, sir.
We thank the school governing body. We bring a lot of praise on the principal, the educator, the pastor.
How many principals have been here?
Oh, you're asking me a hard question, but I can check for you.
Yes, sir.
Life always gives you challenges. Life always has challenges. And what's important is how we rise to those challenges.
Yes.
So for us, at our institution, nothing is stopping us. You know, we have a good team, an excellent team. There's Board of Governors, there's our school SEM, there's our parent component, there's our educators. It's teamwork. When the day is done, everybody puts their hands together to make things work. I have a good team.
All right.
I have an excellent team. A team that will not question in being involved in a project or a program. We have built lots of trust to each other. School is open, we have a transparent system of government or institution. We get everybody involved in making decisions. So all of us become accountable for collective decision making. So each of us is making decisions. Pandemic has changed the way we now engaging. We've certainly wiped the entire institution. Thanks to our ex-learner, Mr. Rishen Nancy, the director of Simple Tech. Our ex-learner came to school through our IT teacher, Mrs. N. Governor, at a 96% pass rate. It is certainly the hard work of the educators, definitely our parents, because you're at home for all the time. And certainly our parents would have guided those learners, our educators doing online lessons. And like you asked, what has changed? We have graduated from doing the WhatsApp lesson to now moving to the Zoom lesson, and then opening our own YouTube channel, for example.
Wow.
We can upload all our lessons. But the manner in which to bring all our children together from different environments, different socioeconomic conditions is, firstly, through sports. Sports is a leveling field. You don't have learners who are now saying, I'm this person, I'm that person. It certainly brings together the issue of camaraderie amongst people. Then, for example, in our curriculum, we have to make certain that through our curriculum, we teach learners that all learners are important. There's equality between all our learners. Nobody is inferior, nobody is superior. So the curriculum must certainly address themselves. The assembly programs. The programs that you have at assembly must be multicultural, must talk multi-faceted. We must talk to the learners that belong to every group, whether it's race, whether it's religion. And we're happy to announce that at our school, we have learners of all religions attending service, for example. So when our teacher, Mr. Chetty, organized the program, she organized a program where all learners are involved. Right? So by doing that, you have all learners working together. You don't see a distinction between learners. Everybody is now working together to make certain that things are happening together. All right? At our school is a demand for space. VERULAM Secondary School is 70 years old. The school doesn't have the infrastructure to now cater for the increasing demand for space. Like I mentioned to you, we have a great many years already. And the population of VERULAM Secondary School at our school has increased from 600 in the last 25, 30 years to over 1,000 learners. So the infrastructure itself is not able to cope with the demands of this increasing space. But I think see the good in every situation. Do good, be good, see the good, like I said again, in every situation. And there'll always be hurdles, there'll always be obstacles. How we respond to the obstacles and the hurdles will allow us to emerge at the end of all those things as a far better individual. Positivity is excellent. Don't be hamstrung. Don't be grounded by negativity. I think as an individual, as a principal of this institution, there'll always be challenges. You can't please everyone all the time. But within your heart of hearts, you must understand, when you have a rest of the day, I've done the best that I can do for everyone that I've come to contact with. And like I tell my children, reach for the sky. Even if you fall, you will land amongst the stars. And for me, that's what it's about.
Thank you very much, sir.
But I must thank you for the opportunity of coming to our school. And I'm sure you spent many hours today, more than you wanted to spend. And yeah. You had an idea of what the day is like at school. Yeah. Busy, exciting, and I think all staff members will love it when you're glad to come together.
Thank you very much, sir. Thank you as the school news owner, we are saying thank you.
Thank you very much.